Welcome to my nightmare, despite there is no moral to this story. There ain't no glory, it's gory. I got a war looking for me over my shoulder. It's creeping, constantly coming, I'm ducking. They all...
Okay, so happy 4th of July, first of all. Obviously, I don't have on pink today. I got on my Captain America shirt. Full-fledged geek gear for the 4th. But anyway, first, I'd like to address the haters. Hi, I'm so glad that Drake and Lil Wayne are like your personal best friends, that you're so offended that I made a video about them. So, cheers to you, man. So today's topic I'd like to talk about is death of Autotune. The reason why I want to talk about the death of Autotune is it was a necessary thing to be said, first and foremost. The thing about it that makes it that much more important is that we have a major artist like Jay-Z who came out and said it. Because we already see what happened. I'm sure my Drake and Lil Wayne fans is going to be all mad at me again for saying this, but the Autotune is played out. The Autotune is played out. Unless your name is T-Pain or DJ Quick, it's played out. It just is. That's how I feel. You're not going to change my mind about it. But had I said that, and some of y'all are still going to say this, I would be a hater. The death of Autotune. Had it not been Jay-Z that said it, if it would have been anybody else, it could have been Common, it could have been Mos Def, it could have been Talib Kweli. It could have been me. It could have been a number of other underground rappers. Lupe Fiasco. It could have been Little Brother. It could have been The Roots. It could have been Pharoah Monch. It could have been so many other people. Joel Ortiz. It could have been so many other people that said it, that y'all would just flat out be like, y'all haters. Y'all haters. Move on. Hip hop has moved on. Okay, but evolution is not always for the better. And right now, the hip hop game is definitely taking a turn for the worse. If you don't believe me, you know I'm gonna throw examples in here. You know
I'm gonna throw examples. All white bricks, white tan bricks, just get a lick, for 50 more bricks, falling like a bitch with all these bricks, bricks. 36 tips, that's a whole shit. Want a bad bitch, gotta have bricks.
It is taking a decline, and I'm glad it took somebody like Jay-Z to come out and say it. Now, some of y'all are still gonna hate on Jay-Z because some of y'all is babies and don't remember Reasonable Doubt Jay-Z. Don't remember Hard Knock Life Jay-Z. All y'all know is Beyonce's husband. Y'all don't know. Y'all know Jay-Z the executive. Y'all know Jay-Z, I'm off of presidents to represent me, Jay-Z. Y'all don't know that Jay-Z. So the death of Autotune to us, to real hip-hop, to true school, to old school, we is loving this right now. Excited, and I'm trying to do good and not swear because I really want to say we loving this shit. Fuck it, I'm going to say it. We loving this shit. We glad Jay-Z came out and said it because somebody needed to. Somebody had to say it.
You rappers singing too much. Get back to rap, you keep painting too much. I'm a multi-millionaire, so how is it I'm still the hardest here? I'll be in the project hallway, talking about how I be in the project all day. That sounds stupid to me. If you a gangster, this is how you prove it to me. Yeah, just get violent. This is death of Autotune, moment of silence.
Cause y'all think everybody is haters every time they have their own opinion. And since this is the 4th of July, let's bring this up. Freedom of speech. I'm not gonna knock nobody because they a Drake fan, because they a Lil Wayne fan, because they think I'm a hater, because they like them, because I'm a fat bitch, I need to clean my house, whatever. It's freedom of speech. But let me use my freedom of speech right now and say, these people is not your friends. These people do not know you personally. They is not gonna give you free tickets to a show because you defending them to me. About it. Is that a lot of y'all that's coming out saying like this very vulgar stuff, and don't get me wrong, I swear, I'm also a grown woman, I graduated college, I'm educated. Some of y'all is coming on the thing cussing at me, spelling cuss words wrong. You know how uneducated you gotta be to misspell a cuss word? I mean, really? I'm gonna try to stop doing it on my videos because obviously y'all think that's cool and it's not. I know how to speak intelligent. It's just some circumstances, if I'm pissed off enough or it's just that level of something that needs to be said, then I will. Yeah, but a lot of y'all think that's cute. Y'all are 16 and 17 year old calling people all kind of fat bitches and cussing. It's not cute. Okay? And again, for you to defend some celebrities that y'all don't even know, all I'm doing is placing my opinion. Freedom of speech. So I'm not telling y'all don't do it. Matter of fact, I love it. I love the hate. I live for it. I live on being hated on. I've been hated on my whole life. Trust and believe it. Trust and believe it. I live in Haterville, Youngstown, Ohio. Trust and believe. I grew up on hate. So I love it. Feed me, Seymour. Feed me more of it. But for y'all to be cussing and defending these people y'all don't even know, y'all need to wake up and smell the coffee or the blunt or whatever it is y'all smoking, because I know some of y'all is doing that too. And just realize what y'all defending. That's all I'm asking you to do. The only reason why I'm doing these videos is to open your eyes of the demise that hip-hop is taking and what it's doing to us as a black community. No disrespect to the white people that's watching the videos, because I'm not racist or anything like that, but I'm just saying, like, our culture has been set back. As an original, like, somebody that grew up on hip-hop, it took us so far, it took us so long to get accepted as a real music form, for people to realize that this was an actual culture, for people to come along and start doing derogatory songs towards women, talking about nothing but cars, drugs, money, pussy, bitches, and I'm going to say it because I'm saying it in their words, how they were saying whips, chains, like y'all slaves. And then I actually had somebody get mad at me and say it because I called somebody a coon. I never said that. I said what the music industry right now is doing is reflecting our young black men as coons. That's what they want to do. And our young black women as hookers and whores and women with no morals. And that's why you got songs like I did on the last video. I like the way she worked with no panties on. Since when did you have so many songs about strippers? Since when did you have so many songs about creeping on the side with somebody else? I mean, like, you don't even hear love songs no more. It's all about, I want to screw, or I got a woman, but I'm screwing this person on the side, or I'm boyfriend number two. That's what it's turned into. Now, mind you, I know it started out being Death of Autotune, but damn it, I done got up on a whole nother tangent, because this is a little bit more important than Death of Autotune right now. For real, all I'm asking y'all to do, like I said, feel free to hate on me like Cat Williams said, and act like my hair ain't luxurious when you know that it is. But what I'm saying is, please, just pay attention to what y'all listening to. Pay attention to what y'all listening to. Like, really? Really? For real? Like, y'all think that's cool? But it'll just be calling you all kind of bitches and hoes, and ain't talking about nothing but wanting to have sex with you. Like, you really think that's cool? Dudes, you really think it's cool? Like, I grew up on Public Enemy, dude. Fight the Power. They was teaching things. You really think it's cool that all the songs ain't nothing about what kind of kicks you get? And what color your car is, and your whole song is 15 different ways to say your car is blue with rims on it in 15 different ways? Like, that's clever to y'all? Come on, man, wake up. That's all I'm saying. So freedom of speech, and everybody is free to say what they want to say. That's freedom of speech. I just bought a Two Live Crew Nasty As They Want to Be t-shirt, and we'll rock it with the thongs on it and everything. But it's not because they degraded women. I wasn't down for that. But it's freedom of speech, and they was the first rap group that had to stand up for that. So in closing, it is freedom of speech. I'm just asking you as a consumer, as the listener, the industry is not going to change unless we change what we're buying, unless we change what we're listening to. And as long as y'all think it's cool for them to degrade women, and I talk about nothing but doing drugs, selling drugs, smoking drugs, drinking, it was to teach you that that ain't what you want to do. Hov did that, so hopefully you ain't gotta go through that. Not cause it's cute. Not cause you can put the rims on the car and you got all the bitches because you selling all the bricks. Look, I'm getting frustrated. I'm done. You already know what it is. JP, holla.